What's up, blockchain? How y'all doing today? It's Crypto Music Mitch coming at you with a little bit of this and that, doing some crypto news and some updates and all that stuff of how we're breaking in this cash. So, huge drop in the price leader below 50. We're now at 49.772. Had a big old correction just recently. It doesn't really matter for me. I personally want the price to go down. I know I'm one of the only ones who thinks that, but I want to gather as much Bitcoin as I can. So as far down as the price can go, great. Look, Litecoin bled down to 189. Stellar down to 40 cents. Chainlink down under 30, down to 27.13. Right now is a great time to get in. Aave below $400. I mean, looking pretty good. Uniswap down to 23 bucks. Great time to get yourself in on some seriously great projects. For me, I primarily trade crypto to crypto assets. So, you know, for me, getting my USD in, I usually don't trade a lot in USD pairs. I try to trade primarily in crypto pairs. So I don't really give a crap how far up, how far down the price goes. Monero down to 200. Nice. But, you know, things are on sale right now. Bitcoin fell sharply on Monday and continued declining into early Tuesday session as traders feared excessive valuations after a 100% rise this year. The benchmark cryptocurrency lost more than 8,000 or 13.91% to trade below 50,000, and at its week-to-date low, it was changing hands for as much as $46,700. Ah! Pretty great. You would like to got in on there. Already up. Bitcoin's closest market rivals, Ethereum and Binance Coin, also fell 20 and 17% in the same period, respectively. One thing on Binance Coin, yeah, they got the fees thing figured out, but I think in the end, the Binance blockchain is, it can't touch Ethereum. Why? Decentralization. The Binance blockchain, don't get me wrong, I'm bullish on all things crypto, and especially, you know, I think that there's, as long as the fees are high, that chain's going to do fine, and it's also going to help out a lot of other chains. But the difference between a centralized chain and a decentralized chain cannot be understated. Like, the government coming in and shutting down Binance, that could happen. But Ethereum's already been, you know, been deemed not a security. That's the green light towards institutional investors. How many institutional investors do you think are buying BNB? You know, above board? Not many. You know, some of them below board for sure. But yeah, the point being that I think BNB is a great place to be for a while, but it's probably not the place to be for the long term. So Grayscale prepares for DeFi future with new cryptocurrency. I believe that's a new cryptocurrency offering. Asset manager BlackRock is starting to dabble in Bitcoin. And this one, Rothschild Investment Corporation raises stakes in the Grayscale funds. And what happens to the trailing price of Grayscale lists it? All huge news stories, you know, which are going to have major effects on the price. So let's stop by Daisy real quick. Daisy has released its white paper. The trading's been going good, even with the big giant dip that the entire crypto market saw. We're only seeing a little tiny dip. In total rewards, we're 89.3%, but in total compound P&L, this price can fluctuate. I'm now up to 19.2% since this thing has launched. So, and it was already up higher than that, but with the entire dip, you know, we dip some too. So that's just the way it is. Your realized rewards won't change, but your compound P&L will. So these guys have just been killing it since we've been in, and I couldn't be more excited. In case you're not familiar with Daisy, they are basically the world's probably largest and most effective algorithmic based traders. And you can't get into EndoTech, but you know, it's mainly for institutional investors. Like, if you want to have EndoTech running on your exchange on Gemini, you know, you got to pay like $125,000 as a fee. You need at least $1 million to put on your account, not more than $10 million. And then these guys will trade for you. And they've been, you know, this is backed, this is brought to you by Anna Becker. Well, here, we'll just go to the team real quick because kind of says it all. Here we are. About. So that red right there means the market's in serious drop down decline. This is the co-founder Anna Becker, Dmitry Gushkin. These guys are super brainiacs, longtime traders, hugely trusted in the regular financial markets, but also paving and blazing roads. Big time trailblazers here in the crypto community since they have launched their own Tron contract. There was way too much information on that Tron contract, and they had to break it down, separate it into a whole bunch of contracts, and they're going to relaunch. Only the people who got in at the beginning have been earning the rewards I just showed you, but this is going to be opening up to everybody very soon, and this is the place to be for to be in the markets and to have, you know, your money somewhere and it's trading not on your own account. This is probably the greatest opportunity out there. Look at the crypto market up to 1.7 trillion. Can you believe that? That's less than a month ago. We're saying, oh, will we ever break a trillion? Will we ever break a trillion? We're at 1.7 trillion. That's like more than halfway to 2 trillion. Crazy. A doubling of market in this much. You got to expect some pullbacks. You got to expect some major, major volatility like this. Look, Matic down 58.2%. Algo down 64%. BEC down 50. And here's your ups. So yeah, I'm really happy to be involved here. This is on the, you know, they do pay out in Tron on the Tron blockchain, and it links directly to your wallet. It's completely, you know, smart contract, all that good stuff. And they have recently just launched their white paper. We'll take a look at that right now. Okay, this is the DAISY white paper that's just been released. It looks pretty good. It's got all mainly about their trading and the different stuff they got going. And, you know, just kind of a lot of the mumbo jumbo you would expect, but it is nice to see. It's nice to have this out, kind of just kind of outlines their road for the future and all that good stuff. And it's pretty impressive. It's got some really good stuff in here. I recommend reading it. If you go to daisycrowd.com, you will find it there. I believe it's daisycrowd.com. It's this one here. Yep, daisycrowd.com. And you'll see this little pick thing here, DAISY white paper. Read here, and that will pop it up for you. You can't currently, you know, copy it or put it anywhere, but you can read it out loud or read it on video even. So sustain high risk, high return investments. While sustaining high risk, high return investment is a new retail ambition, it has long been the goal of hedge fund managers. Despite the fact that hedge funds actually underperformed the market in 2020, they underperform it every year on purpose. Anyway, there are good reasons to believe that certain hedge fund algorithmic approaches to investment represents a good model for high risk, high return retail investors. Yeah, I'm very excited about DAISY and everything going on here. And this is the best place to park your funds and earn crypto on a trading type scenario. There are some other great opportunities out there, but as far as algorithmic traders, no one touches these guys. And if you get to the top level in DAISY, you can have them trade on your account for free. It's the cheapest and best way to get there. Okay, in other news, Fox Business News hires Larry Kudlow. Can you believe that? Larry Kudlow is like the Mr. V-shaped recovery guy. Totally just, you know, propaganda, lies, nothing that is even close to honest. And now Fox Business has hired him. So you can, you know, Fox Business and all those, though they're the pump and dump crew, right? They're getting you to buy the bags of their masters. And that's pretty it. Also, in other news, the new Fed president, Kaplan, says the U.S. economy is going to grow by 5% next year. In this pandemic, in this, you know, scamdemic, in all of this crap going on, he says that the economy is going to grow 5%. It ain't going to happen, guys. I don't care how bad you manipulate those numbers. This economy is in a free fall. The difference between the real economy and the Wall Street has never been greater. And that's why they keep you in your homes. That's why they keep you locked up. They have to, because if the money velocity starts going, hyperinflation will occur. Hyperinflation cannot occur while the money velocity is down to zero. Why is the money velocity down to almost zero? It's because everyone's home. No one's doing anything. No one's working. They're 70% of all businesses that have shut down will never come back. And that is by design. That is on purpose. And expect more, guys. Crude oil is being propped up by the military industrial complex and Wall Street, and anything touching crude oil, expect that to stay inflated for a while. It is not being allowed to drop to its natural price. Janet Yellen says we need more debt. Can you believe that? More debt, like more money being printed. So you can expect this drop in the market to be a short-term blip on the screen, because you can expect this 48.72, like I said, short blip on the screen, because they're just gonna keep printing more money. Sure, we went up, we crashed down. Like, we'll take a look at the Bitcoin chart right now. It's gruesome. I got that pulled up on Who. Look at that drop. Isn't that crazy? That is showing some serious weakness. But you can expect this to be bought up in short order. These guys are footing the price to try to buy up as much as we can. The same thing I said, remember when China a few years back, if you weren't here during the 2017, the price used to get tanked all the time because China was buying up all the crypto. They'd come out with this news and say, we're gonna ban it. This is happening. And the price would tank. And they'd buy it all up. Next week, they'd come out and say, oh, we're thinking, never mind about that, banning it. And we're actually allowing new regulations to help miners. A few months later, they'd be like, banning mining, banning exchanges. We're raiding these places. And the price would tank and they'd buy it all up. Well, now what we're seeing here, and I said this to Crypto Lark when we were first entering the new bull market. I said, remember when China and all of them used to FUD the price to buy up more? Well, now you're going to see American investors and American banks, all those companies, we're going to be doing that now. And we're as good at it as China is. So expect volatility. Expect this thing to rock back and forth and, take advantage of it. That's all you can really do. Stopping into AMB cryptos, and I just thought this story was great. Wisconsin woman who paid in Bitcoin to hire a murderer on the dark web was charged. Guys, Bitcoin is not anonymous, as you know, but this chick didn't realize that. She had some hitman said, hey, pay for it on with BTC. Well, you know, she should insist on paying in Monero or in paying in Energy or Dash or something that is a lot harder to be fined, because with SegWit and all that good stuff, you know, they showed up at her house and dragged her off because, in a message from the 3rd of December, Harper allegedly described the victim's physical appearance and shared personal information such as the man's phone number, his vehicle, and where he worked. She also wrote, the target needs to be killed. So, yeah, you can't go paying for stuff in Bitcoin. You know, that's totally traceable. So, probably not the best. Now, if you got yourself into some privacy coins, that might be a better way to go. Especially privacy coins are really expected to be doing quite well. The more shenanigans, more crazy stuff, the more, you know, SEC regulations and all that, the more you should see these privacy coins jump up. I'm sure you're aware that Monero, CIA gave out, is offering like multi-million dollars if you can teach them how to crack Monero. So, you know, they don't like this. They don't want this here. Dash, also a great way to go. I love Dash. Think it's a killer crypto. The strength of the cryptocurrency market appears to be spreading to privacy-focused coins. The calm price action of Bitcoin often sets up an intense period for altcoins to rally, where several groups of coins can start becoming bullish. So here's how it works. People buy into Bitcoin, right? You flood into Bitcoin, it goes up. People are, they now got profits, right? You bought it 40,000, it goes up to 50,000. You're like, oh, I want to take profits. So they take those profits, maybe their core position trading or whatever they're doing, or their grid trading, but they end up with profits, not more Bitcoin. So now they have these profits, like, well, what do I do with them? Well, then they sink them into other cryptos, right? So what happens is when the Bitcoin price goes up and people pull that money out and pull it into altcoins, that's a good thing. So now the price comes down of the entire market, right? And what happens? A bunch of new investors come in and start buying the dip. We create a new floor, a new price point, because if you all the people are coming in and buying right now at 49,000, never been profit, right? They're not on profit on that Bitcoin. And they're not gonna take profit on that Bitcoin until it goes way up. So you're resetting the floor. And that's where you get different levels of resistance and support. By having a dip creates a natural new level of resistance. Wherever it bounces off of, where it comes off of, there's the resistance, or the support, and wherever it starts bouncing off to, that's your new resistance. But that money changing hands, the Bitcoin changing hands and people taking profits is the most wonderful thing that can happen, because that's what sets a new price floor to go up later. So corrections are always, unless it's huge dips and no volume, are always like the most bullish thing on the planet, and that's what you want. Let's stop by, let's talk about a crypto I think is going to do real well. This is today's altcoin pick, and I'll start giving you some altcoin picks that I'm getting into as we go along here. We're going to talk about FRAX share. FRAX share is having a, you know, right now, this is a killer buy, $7.74. I expect this to go up quite a bit. And in the short term, FRAX is, all right, in the DeFi space, when you see things that are like governance token, know that the governance token now in DeFi, it used to be that was like a worthless token to do voting and to do different, come up with different governances and, come to a consensus and have everyone vote and this type of thing. But now with that governance token is coming, especially when it's like this is a stable coin, FRAX, but they have this other thing called the FRAX share, right? And that FRAX share, so you got FRAX, that's your stable coin. See how the price stays like that? The algorithmically made stable coin. And then FXS is the governance token. And that's what's gonna go up, go down, and move all around based on the use of the FRAX, how well it stays in. Now, you can do different liquidity pools here where you have like four different stable coins plus whatever coin you're farming, right? We won't get into that right now. But just know this is going to be used to bring stable coins to the DeFi world in a great way that people can do all sorts of farming and all sorts of yield farming and different things using these algorithmically based stable coins. And there's arbitragers who like instantly balance this price, and so it's more likely to stay at a dollar, the FRAX, than pretty much anything else. as time goes on, this will be more likely to stay at a dollar than Tether or anything else. Anyway, so the governance token, which you're seeing a lot of this stuff, in order to get around different regulations, no one can come after you if you have a governance token, right? It's just a way to vote. And you say on your site, this is a useless token, this useless governance token, but actually that's where the value is hidden. And we're doing that to hide from regulators, but that's the only thing that can grow in price. And that's where the money and all that feeds into this FXS share. And this price is way down right now and looking pretty bullish in the near term. So here's a look at the chart, down to 758. Man, I wish I had waited to bought in, because I bought a whole bunch at $9. But, wasn't expecting this giant crash right now. But no big deal. I'm not worried about it. Wait, is it a good time to get into FXS at the moment? I believe it is. We just got a major drop, but not so much that the price. The whole crypto market's tanking down, but we're a long way from all-time highs. There is a lot going on. They just got listed on Binance. So pretty crazy. And they're the first algorithmic coin to be listed on Binance. And, on the ranging from 9, some good arbitrage opportunities down to all these ones these are outliers. Don't worry about those. These ones here, 8.59, 8.8888, and you saw right there on the Who, we could get for 7 right now. So really good opportunity there on Who. Who's the cheapest price as of right now? Probably do a refresh here and check out a lower price. Anyway, here we are over on FRAX on the Twitter from where they're at here. We'll just go through a couple things here. The first algorithmic stable coin integration ever in DeFi options with FRAX. Investors of the fractionally algorithmic stability mechanism, FRAX, is the first stablecoin with parts backed by dollars and parts algorithmic. So, pretty interesting. New FRAX pool on FineXUS options protocol. The best money allows you to settle debts, options, trades, and purchases in a decentralized manner. We're excited to announce FRAX can now be used to settle, write, and exercise options on FIN on that platform. Projects whose token is already integral to the integrity and function of their dApps. We got Aave Synthetics. There's FRAX right there. Nice. Basically, empty set dollar is turning into a clone of FRAX Finance. Yep. Of course, people are going to copy what they're doing here. FRAX API. And here we are. They're getting listed on Binance this week. Binance BSC listed FXS. Pretty awesome. And that makes them the first algorithmically pegged to the dollar on coin on there. Also, if you have an idea of what should be covered next, please tag them in the comments below. Ideas, FRAX Finance. Yep, definitely think you should cover FRAX Finance. FRAX Finance become the first algorithmic stablecoin listed on Binance. This is a great point. What makes BTC special is the Anyway, there's a lot going on here. Listing on Binance is going to be huge, and I'm expecting a nice rise out of this in the short term. So even though I picked up FRAX at 9, I wish I'd waited till 764, but I'm calling it for you guys at 764. Not financial advice, all that good stuff. But been killing it on my altcoin picks. But yeah, FRAX share right now. This dip is a great time to buy in here. But anywhere under 10 bucks, I think you're going to be just fine. That listing on Binance should see some serious wins in the sales over the next little bit. Look at this super evil guy here. Bill Gates says Bitcoin is only for billionaires like Elon Musk. Of course, he wants you to be a slave. I think you all know that. Anyway, moving on. Anyway, the IPX airdrop is happening, and there is only this many tokens left, but they're doing a total of 10 millions as a in a DeFi project. So, you know, these airdrops lately have been a great way to go, and have been, you know, ever since the Uniswap airdrop, people are just froth for airdrops, and I think this is a good one. IPX is going to be a DeFi centered token, so there's all that good stuff. And they, you know, they, this is a huge ecosystem from ERK, the Eureka Exchange. IPX is also ran by the Eureka X, which has, you know, bots that you can put on your account. You can send money into them and have them trade on you, on their account, and earn 10% a month. All sorts of stuff, great stuff going on with IPX, ERK, Eureka X, all that good stuff. But the ImpulsX, I got about over 1,000, you know, like 1,700 loaded in there. And I want to get a couple more grand loaded in there, because at about 2,000 a month, you'll pull out about $100 a week with that, you know what. Anything over about $4,000, you're pulling out about $100 a week out of ImpulsX, and you know, that's a trade. Every one of those, that's a trade for me, right? And yeah, so not a bad airdrop to get in on, and good to get as many DeFi tokens as possible. So not a bad way to go there. One of my favorite exchanges has been CoinEX for a good long time. They've gone through a lot of different changes and have always been super solid. You know, they're just one of the greatest exchanges out there. And they're also, they own Via BTC, which is one of the largest mining facilities in the world. Or, you know, percentage of mining done, they're always in the top two or three and always have been. And it's that Via mining that gives the liquidity to CoinEX, and you can get in there and do all sorts of mining and all sorts of different stuff like that. The percentages are rather low, so I, you know, I'd rather trade. But they have their own coin called CET, and the coin took a serious bump because they burned it. The CoinEX token burn is the highest one ever carried out by the exchange, CET, and here's someone covering it. But yeah, look at this bump, and it went even higher than this. My favorite exchange is a native token. It's blasted through resistance, looking bullish AF. Go CET, go CoinEX. And yeah, look at that bump. I mean, it's been crazy. And these guys, yeah, here was the 100.8 billion burned. The team was holding those coins in just all at once, and like, just like all of a sudden, CoinEX decides to burn 1.8 billion coins, and it just shot the price up super nice. I was holding a bunch, and I was in quite a few trades. Anyway, I took a whole bunch of nice trades on this thing, pumping and dropping, and it has been fantastic. And like I said, this exchange has just been one of my favorites. I hold quite a few of the CET, and saw the value of my holdings go up, and I managed to scrape out another 1,000 or so coins. I was at 16,000 before, and now I'm up to 17,681. And if it bumps around again, I will certainly make a few more trades and grab up as many as those as I can. And so last but not least, Actually, I think we're gonna leave it there. We've covered a lot of stuff. It's getting pretty late, and I got a whole list of stuff here I still want to talk about, but ran out of time. So there's all that. A lot of good stuff going on. I got a lot more coming your way. A lot of exciting stuff going on, especially, you know, with the bull run and everything. And I love these drops. That's where I really rake it in. And, you know, I trade crypto to crypto charts primarily using grid type strategies and a lot of different other strategies. But, you know, been cleaning it up. I know a lot of people got cashed out with that, in ETH and Kraken, right? So there was this crazy Kraken drop that just, you know, looked like stop hunting almost, but it was probably where a lot of the dump happened from ETH, right? Look at this crazy ETH flash crash to $700 on Kraken. Nowhere else really did that. It didn't happen on Binance, didn't happen on CoinEX, didn't happen almost anywhere, but on Kraken, that's probably where they dumped all the Ethereum before all the algorithmic, you know, arbitrage bots started filling this in from the other exchanges. You can see what that did to the price. And you know that when anyone dumps that much on one exchange, they're doing it on purpose, and they're on other exchanges shorting. That's how they make their money, dumping, right? If you can get the price even just a wick down and you set yourself up on a bunch of, you know, perpetual exchanges and margin trading, leverage trading to profit from that. I mean, this has gone on historically forever. And it's like one of the reasons, like, you know, people like China could dump all the American currency. And like, China wouldn't dump the American currency just to hurt you. They dump the currency and then short on all the exchanges in the world and rake in huge amounts of profit. So, you know, people say, China holds all this U.S. currency, so they want the U.S. currency to go up. Not necessarily. It gives them a position of power so that at any point in time, it's like a threat. Hey, we can dump these dollars and we'll short the market and make money. The governments all know this goes on. And they'll say to us things like China holds this, but they want the dollar to stay strong because they hold so much debt. No, that's not why they're holding it. They're holding it as a threat over your head. They can make money whether they dump the dollar or hold on to the dollar. If the price goes way down, they'll just short it, right? They'll dump it and make the price drop, just like you see here. It happens in economic politics. It happens everywhere. It happens in oil. Like, for instance, Mexico keeps a short on oil to stop OPEC from ever dropping the price too far. Because if the price ever drops too far, all the banks pay Mexico billions of dollars. It's actually one of the coolest things that is done with a short ever. ETH is what for Kraken? ETH USD down to 700. That was pretty crazy. Look at this flash crash here. Someone else showing it. And so it looks like Kraken broke, this guy said. But it's just because that was where the person dumped it, right? It's not Kraken's fault they dumped it on their exchange. It's just the way it goes. I'm a big fan of the CEO from Kraken. I think he is a Bitcoin badass, man. I love that guy, and everyone in crypto should act a lot more like that. Anyway, there's a lot going on. I got so much more I wanted to talk about, but couldn't cover it, so I'll catch you guys on the next one. Like, subscribe, all that jazz. Crypto music is going to catch you on the next one. Hope you're having a hell of a great day. Better chop this up or no one's going to watch it. And out.